So good morning. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to this session on waste management. We are
Roma, we just like to have a little introductory session. So Amita will introduce you and then start with a little prayer as well.
Thank you, ma'am. Good morning, respected Shobha ma'am, coordinator of activities, Mrs. K.C. Maya, dear staff members, children and guests. I am honored to welcome today Mrs. Roma J. Vinayak in this webinar on waste management organized by Tarumitra Club. Before we proceed further, we would like to start today's program by seeking God's blessings.
That as we worship you, Lord, come and change our lives. Arise, 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 shake your place, be enthroned on our praise. Sing, arise. One thing we ask of you, one thing that we desire, that as we worship you, Lord, come and change our lives. Arise, 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 take your place, be enthroned on our praise. Arise, King of Kings, Holy God, as we sing, arise. We lift you up, we lift you up, we lift you up on our praises. We lift you up, we lift you up, we lift you up on our praises. We lift you up, we lift you up, we lift you up on our praises. We lift you up, we lift you up, we lift you up on our praises. Arise, 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 take your place, be enthroned.
Thank you. Ms. Vinayak, she's a founder of EcoWarden, a socio-environmental cause promoting culture and environmental consciousness. Ms. Roma is currently leading her team of volunteers for slum and rural awareness with regard to waste management and implementation of soil segregation with support from Gurugram Municipal Corporation. We welcome and request Ms. Roma to speak today on how we, the urban citizens, can play an important role in combating plastic pollution and environmental degradation of soil, water, and air. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, ma'am. I start with my famous quote that the environment is in us and it is not outside us. The trees are our lungs, the rivers are our bloodstream, and what we do to the environment is what we are doing to ourselves. So with this, I want to start my presentation. And yes, I want to start with this IPCC report that came just on 11th of August. Now, this IPCC is the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, and some 14,000 reports were discussed in this. 234 scientists participated in this from 60 various countries to figure out what is happening with the climate. And what does this report say for India? That extreme flooding, South Asian monsoons, India will become stronger in the long run and will lead to heavy rainfall in certain areas, all related to extreme weather events, melting of snow, mountains. We already are going through a pandemic, which, as we all know, is happening because of the man's interference with the jungles. So, yes, and the four key findings are that 95% certainty of, there's a 95% certainty that human activities are responsible for global warming, and carbon dioxide is at an unprecedented level, which has not been seen in last 8 lakh years. The sea level is going to rise continuously and is rising faster than over the past 40 years. And over the last two decades, the Greenland and the Antarctic ice sheet have been melting and the glaciers have receded in most parts of the world, which is a very, very sad and a scary proposition for our future generations and for all of us here. Now, the next image that I'm going to share with you is this image, which is nothing but our Delhi landfill. It's the Ghazipur landfill. And there was a fire that happened in this Ghazipur landfill. And if you can see, this picture has been taken by a drone of this particular landfill. And this is nothing but methane. And these are the greenhouse gases, the carbon dioxide, methane, NO2, SF6. Let's confine ourselves to methane. And amongst the methane that is generated by anthropogenic methane that is generated by man, the landfill and the MSWs are 15% responsible for this, if you see. So 17% of methane comes out from your landfill. And we must know that methane is 84 times more potent a greenhouse gas as compared to carbon dioxide. And the carbon dioxide is going to linger on for hundreds of years, whereas methane is going to stay here for two decades, and it can go away after two decades. So there is a solution to this problem that we have of methane generation. Whatever is in our hands, you know, agriculture is taking up 40% of it. The fossil fuels are taking up 35% of it. And almost 20% our trash is responsible for it. So this whole, this 5-minute lecture that I gave you about IPCC, I just wanted to tell you that what is it and why is it important, and if it even makes sense. This is, again, the video of that landfill fire, if you can see. You know, reading about it is something else, but when you witness these things from your own eyes and you witness when you look at all these pictures, it is something else for all of us. If you see this, the landfill site, two gases mainly, it's carbon dioxide and it's methane. And that's what is of it. Is my This is another landfill fire that happened just about a month ago in my city, and I'm from Gurugram. So we were witnessing all this. So, do you see the intensity? And did you? I hope you all noticed these trucks which are standing there, which are full of our waste. So, every day Delhi is generating about 4,000. Your municipal, the North MCD is generating about 4,500 tons of this waste is coming to your landfill, which is close to you, and it's just endless. Like 2,000 tons is almost equivalent to 500 elephants. So 4,500 must be equal to say about 1,000 elephants. So 1,000 elephants are being generated almost every day. Now they say that India is going to be the world's highest waste generator. And this was done by the World Bank. This data has been given by the World Bank. And so a lot of people are working on this, and they are trying to tell us that who actually is collecting all this data. So there are few agencies who are doing that. One is your Central Pollution Control Board, and the other is your State Pollution, the Ministry of Environment and Forest. And so these are these ministries which are responsible for collecting data on waste, and they tell us. So obviously the ministry is not going to like give us the real picture, right? They will just tell us like, now, can you imagine that, you know, your kachre wala comes and he takes your trash and you think he's going to weigh how much he's collected today, how much is the generation? So the collection of this data is still very sad. Now, if I give you the number that our Ministry of Environment has given vis-a-vis what the World Bank has given, it's a different game altogether. Yes. Oh, can we leave the questions to later on, Bitta? Why don't you note down your questions? Note down your questions and just ask me, okay? Keep noting down your questions and then just keep asking me. Our ministry tells me that about 15 lakh tons of garbage is generated every day in India, which is equivalent to about 37,000 elephants. Now, as you all know that our country is like, you know, there's such constraint, like in 1 square kilometer of our country, 500 people are living. So we have to, our waste is getting generated day by day. This is one growth of ours, which just has been constant and it is constant. So they say that the MOEFCC says that 62 million tons is generated every day, yearly, whereas they say that it is about 277 million tons is what the World Bank's data says. Anyways, we'll just see what it is. Now, India's solid waste collection efficiency is only 70%. That means that in the urban India, only 70% of our waste is collected. And 70% is collected, and out of which only and only 20% is efficiently, scientifically treated. So where does the rest of the 80% go? It goes into those landfills, the one that you just saw. So this is the data, another, that 43 million tons was collected. That means 70% was collected, out of which 31 million tons was dumped in the landfill and only 11 million tons was treated. So MOEFCC estimates that only 75 to 80% of the total municipal waste gets collected and only 22 to 28% is processed and is treated. Now, as we all know, that our Delhi has how many? It has three major landfills. Which is the closest one that is next to you? That's Bhalaswa. And Bhalaswa has been functional since 1984. And in 2006, its capacity was full. And still every day, this landfill continues to receive about 4,500 tons of waste daily. Now, this if you look at this slide, this says that they are processing about 6,000 tons of waste every day. There are about these machines and at least 80 lakh tons of waste is lying in your Bhalaswa. 55 lakh tons is lying in Okhla and 140 lakh tons is lying in Ghazipur landfill. And what they're saying about Ghazipur, Ghaziabad residents say that it will take at least 94 years to clear the waste in Ghazipur landfill. So how are they clearing the waste? What is it that they're doing with the waste? They usually, can you see this machine here? They're putting this entire waste inside this machine. They're just sieving this whole thing. They're whatever, it's a big sieve, chhanani. So whatever they're sieving with whatever, depending upon the diameter of the object which is there, it is divided into either it becomes their inert material or RDF or their reject. So they try to biomine it that way. And they are only using about 24 such machines to process this waste. And with this capacity, it will just take almost about 100 years to finish it off. The Supreme Court had said that the Ghazipur landfill is almost close to Qutub Minar. So Qutub Minar is about 73 meters and our Ghazipur landfill is about 65 meters. Like I said, 29 acres of land. It started in 1984. Saturated in 2002, but till today, your waste is going to those landfills. Now you must read this portion. This is why I put this slide here. It said, why shouldn't garbage be dumped in front of Lieutenant Governor officials' residence instead of harassing common people? That reminds me that your school is just next to there. Now, this is one of the videos that I had clicked myself when we were at our landfill. And I want to talk to you about the kind of pollution that it does. Just take a look. So this black liquid that is coming out, this is called as a leachate. And this comes out when it rains, when there is water inside your waste, then when there is biodegradable material inside your waste. And obviously when it is collected, this black poisonous liquid is usually how it comes out of a landfill and it seeks inside your aquifers. Now, our landfill is just next to our forest. Take a look.
No, aapki bhi photo leti hu main, aap bhi aao sample pe lekar
This is just next to the landfill.
This
I just wanted to see the expression on your faces. If you give me a thumbs up or a thumbs down. Do you like this? You like what you saw? Does it disturb you? You saw the leachate? Let's see some more. Now imagine the plight of this bird. This bird. You know what's going to happen to this, right? So this is what our landfill is. This is where our groundwater aquifers are. And this is where we drink our water from. How far are we from stopping this leachate from getting inside our throats? After all, this is seeping and getting into the ground and going into the landfill and reaching the aquifer. And this is what you and I are drinking, right? It's a very serious issue, children. So this is something about the water pollution. Today, I wanted to just go and Google. I'm not going to give you everything here, but I want you to go and Google and see the status of groundwater contamination in our cities. Is there presence of heavy metals? Now, if you can see, they've put PV, plugs, dead fish, glass, everything, mobiles, batteries. You know, they are all made up of hazardous stuff, chemicals. It's not organic stuff. So all this is getting mixed and it's just cancerous water. About air pollution, they say that out of 30 most polluted cities, 22 are in our country, where New Delhi is the world's most polluted capital. See this report, 2021. PM2.5, PM10, dioxins, furans. These four things, children, remember the names. PM2.5, PM10, dioxins, furans. These are released when plastic is burned. And all our winters are like this, right? Almost all. Many studies in the past have identified particulate matter aerosols particles with diameter less than 2.5 PM2.5 as a major pollutant responsible for haze and fog formation over Indo-Gangetic plain, including Delhi. Plastic burning main cause behind reduced visibility in Delhi. What is polluting Delhi's air? 40% road dust. Construction, 20% industry, 20% transport. They are saying 10% is waste burning. What are the effects of dioxin? Blackheads, cysts, nodules in the skin. Long-lasting damage to human health, immune system, nervous system, hormones, cancer, reproductive and developmental problems. And dioxin is categorized as a persistent environmental pollutant. They are highly toxic and have a half-life of 7 to 11 years. That means once they enter the body, this means that they will stay in your body for at least 35 years. So never, ever inhale. Never, ever inhale plastic. If you see someone burning plastic, just stop them right there. I'm going to share these screens and share all these slides with you. And I want each and every child who's here, children, you should all have this. This is something that you should all know. On your fingertips. That is why I've made concise small slides that I want you all to remember. Okay? Okay? So, we spoke about, I showed you all these leachate pictures. I showed you all these dioxins, that Delhi is the most polluted city in the world, that out of 30, 22 polluted cities are in our country. And out of top 15, almost 14 are here. Out of 20, almost 14 are in this belt of ours where we are living, where you and I are living, the air that we all are breathing. So before I get into waste management, before I tell you why is it important for you to keep your bhindi away from your plastic, you all should know we have a very, very solid scientific backing behind this. Okay, children? Show me a thumbs up. Yeah. So this is what your waste is. Children, please write down all your questions. Keep writing down your questions so that I know. I'm gonna answer all your questions. This is what your waste is. Almost 50 to 60% is your wet, is your organic. It can be used to make compost. 30% can be recycled. 30% of your waste can be recycled. So 50 to 30, 80% of your waste is sorted at home. You should not be sending that to the landfill. 2 to 5% is your e-waste, which comes out very rarely, but it is the most toxic of all. The most toxic of all. The only waste, the rejects that need to go to the landfill, which are only 10%. And we shall discuss what this rejects is. I would want you all to keep asking me, keep noting down in your heads, what is it that these 10 to 15% is going to be? So if 50 to 60% of the waste that is there at your home, if that can be sorted out by making a compost, then literally 50% of the problem is gone. So from 43,000 tons that north of Delhi is generating, maybe we can just come down to like what, some 1,000 tons, which can be so easily managed by the government. Take a look at this. Wait, I don't know what's happening. Just give me a minute. Just give me a minute. Ma'am, just let me know if...
Yes, ma'am.
Let me know if my screen is visible.
Not yet, ma'am.
Okay.
Now it's visible, ma'am.
Okay, thank you.
When we separate and segregate everywhere else, then why not here? If separated at source, waste is a resource. All you have to do is segregate your waste using three bins: green for wet waste, blue for dry waste, and red for domestic hazardous waste. Up to 90% of waste can be recovered and reused through composting, recycling, and effective treatment, resulting in a reduction in landfills and garbage burning, giving us clean air, water, and soil. Remember, once it's mixed, it can't be fixed. Alag karo, har din teen bin.
Alag karo.
Har din teen bin. Did you like that? You liked it? Okay. There's something else that I would want to show you.
Okay, Khamba, when I say action, you go out there, talk about waste, segregation, composting. Nice.
Okay. Okay.
Okay, guys, ready? Silent action!
Hello. Hi. Look at this ugly mess. What is wrong with you people? How can you tolerate this? How can you create this? How can you do this? Firstly, do you segregate your waste? Oh wait, do you even know what segregation is? It's not mixing your organic waste with everything else. It's separating your wet waste and your dry waste. If you separate your waste, you're fine. You're a good person and I love you. Stop watching this video. This is for the others who don't. You, the one who doesn't separate your waste. I'm sure you feel that even if you do it, it's not going to make a difference. Or maybe you just couldn't care less. Or maybe you read in the papers that there's a cool machine that'll take care of all this and make this all into electricity. So no need to worry, right? This is where you're expecting me to say that you're wrong. But I am not going to say that. You're a moron, an imbecile, an idiot, a plot on humanity. I'm sure you're the types who have a dustbin, line the dustbin with a plastic bag, and then chuck anything and everything inside it. Then you tie it up and throw it somewhere, anywhere outside. And now we're running out of space to dump all this rubbish, and no one gets separated into useful piles when it's that much of a mess. And this is the mess that you create, you lazy.
Yeah, so I had to stop that video in between. How was it? Give me some more responses. Yeah? He was a bit rude, right? He was a bit rude. Even I don't like rude people. But sometimes, beta, when we see so much of trash, when we see these mounds and mounds of landfill waste and you see that it's just not stopping at all, then sometimes we just get a little angry. So although I don't propagate you getting angry, and getting angry is not going to resolve this problem. We are not going to sort it out by getting angry. The only way that we can solve this problem is, number one, today you will tell your mother that please, we will segregate our waste. 50% of waste has to be segregated, composted, or given separately. And those of you who are lovely, brilliant children who really feel for the Mother Earth and for the planet will get a composter. You will not buy a birthday present this year, and you will not buy something, maybe a Christmas gift or a Diwali gift, you will not buy one for yourself and you will get a composter for yourself. Okay? Promise me that you will do that. Okay. There is another one that I want you to see. This one is better.
Look at what you've done. I told you not to shout at our audience, our customers. Go back and do this again. Go and be nice.
I'm sorry. I apologize. I haven't even introduced myself. And I've yelled at you. Sorry. My name is Khamba. I'm a composter made by Daily Dump. I turn your organic kitchen waste into compost. Compost is, well, manure. Food for plants, and more importantly, I make it smell-free and hassle-free. So yeah, that's what I do. Why should you do this, you may ask? Excellent question. Why should you do anything at all? let's look at your garbage. Firstly, 60% of this garbage is organic, so that much need not be thrown out if you compost at home. Secondly, 60% of this organic waste is water. So when you mix it with plastic or sanitary waste, the water becomes toxic. It seeps into soil and water bodies, contaminating them. Thirdly, when there's curry mixed with paper or battery acid mixed with kitchen waste, it's very tough to separate things for recycling or composting. So do you see? So separate. Once you do that, I do all the composting work. Step one, you just need to bring me home. You keep me in the balcony or garden. Step two, you dump your organic waste in me. Step three, add a layer of this magic powder. This is a new product, remix powder that we've developed. It's organic culture mixed with other materials that absorb water and removes all the bad smell. In 40 to 60 days, the compost is done. Use it. That's it. No stirring, no time spent, no smell. Seriously, that's it. It's that simple. We've made it that simple with this new way of composting. Now, do you have any excuses? So go. Go to this site. You buy me and start. Do it now. We even come in different shapes and sizes, so take your pick. Do it! Or don't do anything. Just sit there and complain about the government and the politicians and your
corporate. Come on, where do you think you're going?
Do you think they're going to do anything about it? No, they're not going to do a thing. These people are hopeless.
Okay, I need to retire.
So this one was better? Yeah? Thumbs up? Hmm? Okay, so Daily Dump is not the only person who's doing it. There are a lot of other companies who are doing it. Lot of information is available on the internet. You don't have to get it just from Daily Dump. Daily Dump happens to be, I like this cartoon a lot. So for all my presentation, this khamba, I really like this talking khamba. So just for, it's like, I like Tom and Jerry. So like for cartoon effects, I usually get this guy. So that is why. Otherwise, there's a lot of information available on the internet. Composting is very easy. It is 30% your green waste and 70% your 3:1 is the ratio. So if one is your green waste, three has to be your carbon. So your leaves and your cocoa peat. So all these, plus the way we use a little bit of dahi to make more dahi, bioculture. So we use a little bit of bioculture, and that bioculture can be anything. It can be obtained from the this thing also. So I would have shown you my composting as well, but it's a little further ahead. But I do this at home. So my composter also, I get all the leaves which are down on the road and wherever I find leaves, I collect my leaves. I segregate my waste at home. I keep it in there is a small bucket, a small basket that I have, a very good looking basket. Because my waste is not waste. It is actually food for the soil that we need. So a lot of my compost is used for all the plants that I'm planting around over here. But we here are doing it at a community level. Our RWA is doing it. And in the colony where I live, our people are doing it together. Okay. So right now, if you can't do this, you can at least get a composter at home if you can't do it on this level. But if you speak to your parents and if you speak to like 6, 7, 10 people, and then we can form a group, and then you can, you know, call a waste management agency. And there are a lot of people who are doing it. So we will see as and when there is more coming. Wait, kids. Okay, so why do I say that I am planting trees and I'm doing that? What I'm doing is, just see, trees per person in India is 28 trees. Global average is 422. Canada, there are 8,953 trees. China 102, Russia 4,461, USA 716. So we also need to breathe na beta. Yes. So compost banao aur ped lagao. Right? Now let's come to plastic. Okay, I think maybe if we can just, there are a lot of questions I see. Can we have like a session, ma'am? Can I just ask these kids to ask their questions?
Yes, ma'am, we can.
Yeah, so go ahead, children. Please ask me. We'll take like 10 minutes of question answer session now. Yes, Bhavi.
Ma'am, my dad, when I was traveling somewhere, my dad, there was a landfill nearby. My dad told, seeing that it was trees there. My dad told that it was a landfill. It is covered with green because when the Olympics in India, then Government of Delhi converted it into trees. So ma'am, I think that how can it be possible that trees are planted?
Okay, so good question. So what they do is they do bioremediation, beta. Okay, one is bioremediation, one is biocapping. So what they do in biocapping is that the waste is going to be there. They cover it with a HDPE, that is a plastic lining, and then they put some soil on it and then they plant trees on it. So the waste is there. It's not gone anywhere. So when it rains, the water percolates and it still continues to be a methane bomb. It still continues to leach into the ground. It's not like it's going to vanish anywhere. So this is called as capping. So capping is not a very great way of dealing with a landfill. How we deal with the landfill is by bioremediation.
Ma'am, so waste, plastic waste and all will not harm the trees.
Beta, see, the trees will extract what they have to extract. Okay. And plants are very intelligent. Like, you know, it's not like plants are usually intelligent. That is, again, we'll have to rely on some scientific reports and data for the scientists to come out and tell us ki is ped mein ji ab mercury nikal raha hai, iske phool mein ab mat khana lead aur arsenic aa gaya hai. So, you know, we are yet to see what this happens. So we'll have to wait and watch. And I say that we shouldn't be waiting for this. Like this, it just seems to be a shortcut. There is no shortcut to the kind of waste management that I'm talking about, that, you know, you have to segregate your plastic. You have to keep your thermometer and your batteries away from the soil, right? Can we have another question? Yes, Jayati.
As we have shown the PPT, there was a diagram.
There was a?
Diagram.
Okay.
Of in that diagram, it was written that road dust is causing the most pollution, 40%.
Mm-hmm.
So how road dust is causing so much pollution?
Beta, when I say road dust, it also means the emissions from the vehicles. Okay. And when the tires are roaming, when the tires are this thing on the microplastics that they're saying that are coming out of the most vulnerable places where microplastics are found are almost the roads. You know, it is not even the ocean these days. They're saying because the rubber that gets continuously, it gets, because of the friction, those plastic particles are released. One is that, and then is the emissions. Then is the because the green belt and the CND and all these wastes are lying just like that. it is majorly a cause of that, you know, our soil is loose, and because of that, so that is one of the main reasons.
Okay, ma'am.
Yes, Arjun.
Yes, ma'am. Good afternoon, ma'am. Ma'am, I wanted to ask a doubt. Like, ma'am, you showed us a diagram, like a pie chart, basically, regarding that how 50% of the waste that we contribute are organic waste, and ma'am, like that pie chart. Well, that time you showed it, showed us there is 2% of e-waste. Ma'am, what does that e-waste?
Beta, e-waste is mobile, battery, okay, wires. So your e-waste is the waste that is your electronic waste. Or, and you know, our lives these days are, everything is around electronics. You and I are talking around electronics. The way our electronic sales are exceeding televisions, batteries, everything. All this is our e-waste. So I want to give you an example. E-waste is one of the most dangerous things. And why? Because one, it is, did you know that the Tokyo Olympics that took place, almost all their medals, have been made by e-waste, right? They've taken out the gold and the silver from their mobile phones.
From the waste.
Yes.
Even the cloth was from waste.
Yes. Yes. So, so that is what your e-waste is. And e-waste is, although every day you're not throwing your mobiles out and every day you're not throwing your this thing out. So it is just on a daily basis, 2% of it has been given to your electronic waste. Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
You're welcome.
Ma'am?
Yes?
As you said that we plant trees, it prevents soil erosion. So building, if we make more buildings, it can also prevent soil erosion because building will be above the soil and soil will be under.
Building, so, yes. Beta, we should know that 70% of India is yet to be constructed. Okay?
Yeah.
If you just Google this. So 70% of construction is yet to happen. And already we have exceeded the weight of biomass and the weight of man-made things. The weight of biomass is lower and the man-made things are weighing more. And 70% of India is yet to be constructed. So, you know, there is a big disadvantage to that. My problem with concrete is that why are trees good? Why are trees important? One, because yes, they will hold the soil. Two, they will recharge your groundwater. Now, what is happening is with the rains that you see, you know, there is no groundwater. Where do you think you and I are getting our water from? It is coming from the groundwater, right? And where is the groundwater getting the water from? The rains, right? So the groundwater percolation needs to happen. We need to recharge our aquifers with water. So, and if you cover everything with concrete and whatever green space is lying, if you cover all that with plastic, baba, hum pani kahan se piyenge? We are not going to get a pipe from Bay of Bengal. No, that's going to be so this thing. So either we ensure that there is plenty of rainwater harvesting that is happening, and all our buildings which are doing ki jo bhi pani aapke chhat ke upar gir raha hai, that you know you are recharging that amount of water. But if everything is covered with concrete, how are we going to do that? Like in Gurgaon, what has happened is that they have allowed 4 floors to be made on each plot. Okay, so if 4 floors are made on each plot, so every floor has 2 cars at least, right, these days. So every floor is given 1111 gate, right? So there is just no tree. Where will the tree go? Where are the trees? The parks, we want to plant palm, you want to play football, where will we plant trees? So that is also a big concern. So our green spaces are very, very precious. And yes, wherever we can, we must compost. Or kuch nahi to apne terrace pe aap log gamle ke andar paudhe uga do. वो बहुत अच्छी चीज
यस
यू शुड यू मस्ट एंड वेर एवर यू फाइंड एंड डोंट लेट एनी वन यू नो यू डोंट लेट एनी वन ट्रैश योर पब्लिक प्लेसेस एंड डोंट लेट एनी वन ट्रैश योर डोंट फाइट विद एनी वन बट जस्ट टेल पीपल मेक फ्रेंड्स in your colonies in your this thing make sure that some or the other activity you people are doing you know plant one tree in one year for one birthday plant one tree look after it for 3 years okay like pani do khana do usko ped ko uska dhyan rakho look after it compost do apni usko okay and they will grow so all is not lost lot of questions
Ma'am,
I've asked you. Yes.
Can I ask something, my ma'am? Dad loves trees, and we have more than 60 trees.
Oh, very good.
Ma'am, can I ask something?
Excuse me, ma'am.
Ma'am, why India can't be restricted from throwing plastic? Ma'am, why can't India become a clean country like Japan? And ma'am, can we make a park, a place green like jungle, ma'am?
Beta, everything can be done provided there is will. You people become the next political leaders of the country. You become the prime minister. I promise to you, we will do this all together. We need to get, so we are 130 crores of us, 1.3 billion of us, maybe more, 1.5 billion of us. All of us need to be there for each other. Okay. So we need to stop people. Nothing is impossible. Agar it is just about time that we just realize what is it that is the right thing to do. Just don't let anyone... I feel what was made in a factory needs to go in a factory, should not touch the landfill. So just be conscious about this, that what is it that you're sending to the landfill? Aaj se jaake apne dustbin check karna ki aapka carbon footprint, aap apna dustbin, aap landfill mein kya bhej rahe ho, bhalaswa mein aapke ghar se kya ja raha hai? That 80 lakh mountain which is there.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Ma'am, can I ask a question?
Excuse me, ma'am.
Ma'am?
Yeah.
Ma'am, a pie chart which you showed in the starting of the webinar, ma'am, it had that about 27% of methane is emitted by the ruminators and about 40% is emitted by the vehicles we use. So ma'am, are there any ways to stop the ruminants from producing that much methane and the vehicles?
How can we stop the ruminants?
Ma'am, but we are
how
using,
do we
ma'am.
Stop drinking milk is what I can tell
ma'am,
you.
No, ma'am, that, ma'am, the Western countries, ma'am are using them to eat, ma'am are eating them, ma'am. Ma'am, according to the statistics, about 10 kgs of beef is consumed by an average person in a month.
Correct.
Yeah, I say, I must say that this is...
Ma'am, but they should
India
not stop
a,
the production
country.
Of beef. Ma'am, they should stop the production of beef.
Yeah.
They should, beta. Yes, they should. But do you know one thing? Yesterday only I was reading this, that out of the entire biomass of the mammals which are there, almost 40% is our poultry, like, you know, our livestock. Pigs, goats, horses, cows, all of them. Humans are 36% and only 4% are wildlife.
Ma'am,
only
but
4% mammals are wildlife. Yes,
ma'am,
it is
the deep, ma'am, the, ma'am.
So they are eating beef. Yes, they are. But we are drinking milk.
Ma'am.
So,
ma'am,
the deep, ma'am, okay, the 70%, ma'am, 70% of the deforested part of the Amazon rainforest is used
yes.
by the cattle
yes.
to feed on it.
Absolutely, absolutely. You're absolutely right, Martin. Absolutely right.
Ma'am, it's Arav.
Okay, Arav. Sorry, sorry, Peter.
Ma'am, excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, yes, Jayta.
So, ma'am, as Arav said that we should eat beef. In Western countries, they eat beef because there are very less number of Hindus. In Hinduism, we say that cow is a holy animal and we can't eat a holy animal.
Ma'am, it is right.
So that is
ma'am,
why.
It also applies on real life.
Yeah. That is main one thing. And India is the country that that is contributing 70% in saving cows and mammals like deer, tigers. So if we also eat them, then every animal will be in the urge of extinction.
So,
but aren't we using them to gain the milk that we drink every day?
Yes, we are. So yes, it's not just cows, it's pigs equally, it's horses, it's goats, it's everything. It's what we are using for our use. Yeah. So there has to be a balance.
Just milk, other animal products as well.
True.
Oil.
So sustainable living is all about, you know, how do you maintain this balance? And the balance definitely has gone off. So, children, can we please come back to environment, right? Yes, can we please come back to environment, and can we please come back to, you know, because these topics are big topics.
Yes, ma'am. Okay?
And we'll have to have a lot of more sessions to maybe have a discussion.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, I'm really sad hearing this.
Ma'am, Greater Noida, that is the, I think, that is in number one. And
children, one sincere request, one at a time, so that the questions can be understandable to everyone, right? Jyoti, if you asked one, please give chance to others. Otherwise, the session will never end.
You can just email me your questions and I'll try to answer them, okay? I will leave my email address and then... you know, if you really have questions, just email me and I'll try to answer as many questions as I can. Okay. Because we have the time limit also, Beta.
Ma'am, can
yes,
I ask
that's
some
true.
Questions?
I need to finish off my slide also. There's a lot that I've just, I'm half.
No, ma'am, they are not actually very big questions. Just to clear my.
Okay, sure, Aditya, please go ahead.
Ma'am, when we burn the peels of that fruits and vegetables, does they also create pollution?
No, beta. They, you know, burning them, they are highly any calorific value. Now, tell me one thing. आप गीले उससे आग लगा सकते हो, like tissue paper, गीले tissue paper को आग नहीं लगा सकते ना? तो जो चीज के अंदर calorific value इतनी होगी नहीं, तो वो तो it's not so burning dry wood. Yes, I would say, yeah, carbon dioxide, monoxide, yeah, it is generally not good. But when, let's just confine ourselves to plastic, because yeah, plastic has so many plasticizers, it has so many chemicals coated on it, like innumerable chemicals coated on it. So these PVCs, when I talk about PVCs, they are the worst, and they are the ones that release those dioxins and furans. And dioxins and furan is... that is something that can actually mutate also, you know, us. It is, they are so harmful. They are carcinogenic. They are.
Yes, ma'am. But, and that PVC, ma'am. Each one of have something of PVC at our
body. Yeah.
Ma'am, may I ask something?
Ma'am, how many times does the peels of vegetables and fruits take to get become
40-45 days, beta. 40 to 45 days.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, yes, what are aerosol particles?
Aerosol particles, beta, they are the ones which come out of these cans, the CFC cans. So these are these chemicals. Also, they come out from these, I think from the emissions of the vehicles also. So very harmful particles.
Ma'am, what is Pramal?
Pramal?
Ma'am, Pramal.
Where did you read this, beta?
Ma'am, the PPT you shown.
Okay, which PPT?
Ma'am, आपने वीडियो दिखाई थी हमको, three videos. Ma'am, उसके अंदर हमने first देखी थी. Ma'am, last two हमको visible नहीं हो रही थी.
Ma'am, last two videos were not visible. Only we can hear the sound.
Yes, ma'am.
Which videos were not? The YouTube videos.
Yes, ma'am.
Because you have shared the PPT. Tab, ma'am, that's why we are not able to.
Only can hear the sound.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. You have to share the full screen, ma'am. By that, we can only see, ma'am.
My chat is
now it's visible.
My chat is visible.
Okay, let's try this again. Just tell me if you can. Wait.
So welcome to my home. This is my kitchen. And I'm going to
can
show
you see
you
anything now?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am. We have stopped sharing.
Just stop sharing.
Children, please.
What I like to do is I like to have this.
Wait, beta. Wait. Give me a minute.
Till then, can I ask my doubt?
Beta, wait a minute. Wait a minute.
Okay, I think it's going to be a. Can you see my screen now?
No, ma'am.
Ma'am, there is a black screen only.
Okay, come back. When I say action, you go out there.
Now also you can't see?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am, it's only showing the ribbon.
Yes, ma'am. The ribbon of some tab.
How can you show this?
I'm only searchable, we can see.
Ma'am, the black screen is there.
The YouTube video.
You just have to change what you're sharing.
So I did change.
Wait.
How?
When you zoomed up.
Wait, stop sharing. I'll...
Yeah, stop sharing first. Now. Basic and yeah, Safari.
Now, can you see children?
Yes, ma'am.
Let's see this again now.
Talk about waste.
Can you see it now?
Composting.
Yes, ma'am.
Fine, enjoy.
Nice.
Okay.
Action.
Hello. Hi. Look at this ugly mess. What is wrong with you people? How can you tolerate this? How can you create this? How can you do this? Firstly, do you segregate your waste? Oh wait, do you even know what segregation is? It's not mixing your organic waste with everything else. It's separating your wet waste and your dry waste. If you separate your waste, you're fine. You're a good person and I love you. You can stop watching this video. This is for the others who don't. You, the one who doesn't separate your waste. I'm sure you feel that even if you do it, it's not going to make a difference. Or maybe you just couldn't care less. Or maybe you read in the papers that there's a cool machine that'll take care of all this and make this all into electricity. So no need to worry, right? This is where you're expecting me to say that you're wrong. But I am not going to say that. You're a moron, an imbecile, an idiot, a blot on humanity. I'm sure you're the types who have a dustbin, line the dustbin with a plastic bag, and then chuck anything and everything inside it. Then you tie it up and throw it somewhere, anywhere outside. And now we're running out of space to dump all this rubbish, and no one gets separated into useful piles when it's that much of a mess. And this is the mess that you create, you lazy.
Oops, that's it. Visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am.
Yes,
now it doesn't work.
Yes, ma'am. This one? Yeah?
Ma'am, actually, my mom's... Ma'am, meri mama kabhi nahi sochti ki hume vegetables or fruit peels fekne chahiye. She makes the manure from them.
Beautiful.
Because she thinks
high
that...
High five to your mom.
Ma'am, because she thinks that the land pollution is very... Very messy and...
Ma'am, again, we are not able to see the YouTube.
Ma'am, it is... Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Are you sending these videos anywhere? No, better no, wait. Wait.
Ma'am, because of some circumstances, I won't be able to continue the webinar, but the teachers are saying that... we have to attend the last, the test we're going to have.
Yeah, so can I just complete my slide?
Sure.
Yeah, because some questions then you might not be able to answer otherwise.
Mama, I have a doubt.
Wait, let me finish off my slide, please, now. Okay?
Let ma'am finish the webinar. Okay?
So we need to, there is another this thing that I would want you to see. Now let me just finish this. So you should know that globally, only 9% of plastic waste that has ever been produced has been recycled. From 1950 till 2015, this was the case. And you should know that these symbols are there behind your plastic. This does not mean that they are recyclable. It just shows what kind of a polymer has been used for the plastic. So one is for PET, two is for HDPE, high density polyethylene, three is for PVC, four is for LDPE, five is for PP, six is for PS, and others is for seven. These are the most complicated. And the most popular one for recycling in India is number one is PET and number two is HDPE. I'll show you later. I don't know if you know about this, that humans produced almost 20,000 bottles per second. Did you know this? Yes or no? Show me your hand.
No, ma'am.
Okay, fine. Enjoy the video now. Can you see the video?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am.
But it's from that
workplace. Where we visualize the
impact on our planet.
Wait.
Today, we're testing the impact of the plastic bottle. We're going to find out how many plastic
bottles.
Yes. Yes, ma'am. Now it is.
Okay, let me just wait. Now is it visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Welcome to the Humanities Impact Test Site, where we visualize the impact of us humans on our planet. Today, we're testing the impact of the plastic bottle. We're going to find out how many plastic bottles we produce globally and what that number looks like in real time. Let's see it. About 20,000 bottles per second. That's 1,000,000 bottles in just 1 minute. What you see here are 20,000 bottles being added to the pile every second, showing how many plastic bottles we produce in real time.
Not the best day for a run, I guess.
To think that only around 9% of this gets recycled. The rest is burnt, ends up in landfills, or drifts around in the ocean. And this continues every minute of
Excuse
every
me, ma'am. I can't hear the slide.
Do we really need...
Can hear, ma'am.
Ma'am, we can.
Well, that was our test for today, folks. Lovely.
Okay, so 20,000 bottles every second. That is the global PET plastic bottle production. Now India generates about 26,000 tons per day, PPD, tons per day. That means about 2,600 trucks of plastics are generated every day. This is 30% of the waste that I was talking about. This is the most popular one, PET. They are making textile out of this. Indian cricket team's uniform has been made out of this. And a lot of our Nike and our Reeboks, a lot of people are using this. So this are all the kacharawalas. Whenever you see the waste picker who's going on the road, he will never leave a PET bottle because it is sold for 16 rupees per kilogram. So it's a good source of income for him. So please collect and give it to your waste collector.
Ma'am?
Yes, Beta, let me finish, please. Okay. Leave your questions. This is again rigid plastic. It is made into downcycled products. They are saying like tiles, furnitures, a lot of that. This is LVP, low value plastic. Low value plastic. Okay. It contains of all your patli theli, your atta, namak, all the dal packets that come. If they are rinsed, segregated, cleaned, they are used for road making. Like every plastic that comes to my house, I send it for road making. MLP is multi-layer packaging, multi-layer plastic. Why is it called multi-layer plastic? Because it contains 4% is aluminium foil. It will have a metal, it will have plastic, and it will have paper on it. So all your Kurkure chips packet, which has that metal shiny thing. So they are made into your bags. There is a NGO in Delhi itself who are making bags out of this. So provided that you clean and just have like a proper system in place. A problem sirf sabse badi problem ye hoti na beta ki wo sirf aadha kilo collect karne ke liye itni dur se petrol kharch karke aana is not feasible for the waste management company. So we always talk in large numbers. So whenever you have a large collection, that is what you need to do. Paper, I think you all are very well aware that one ton of paper is made by cutting 17 trees.
So yes, ma'am, you know.
Trashing trees, whenever you're trashing even like a small bit of paper, please like, you know, think about it. We as it is have such low this thing. Now I wanted to show you about there is this company called TrioTap in Gurugram that we have, where we are sending our white plastic. Just see what we are doing with it.
Hi, I'm Ashay Bhave. I'm the CEO and founder of Thaili. And this is how your sneakers were made. Hi, I'm Ashay Bhave. I'm the
Can you see it?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am. Paused.
No, ma'am, we cannot see.
Ma'am, now it's visible.
Okay. Now visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, CEO and founder of Thaili. And this is how your sneakers were made.
Plastic bags are washed and sanitized. And satanized. They are dried. Dust or hair are removed. They're making this and sending it to Jalandhar. Made the soles. Vegan glue. It's using recycled PET fire fabric. See that? In India, designed in Dubai. So This makes me really happy. This makes me really happy.
Yes,
why? Because usually these Western countries, they are the ones who are sending their trash to us, right? So this is like, we are doing the opposite of it. We are upcycling and sending it to them. It's nice, right? Globally?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Fascinating.
Yes.
Yes. It's really nice. You can see this on Instagram if you want. So where is my plastic going? My plastic is going here for plastic to road. The LVP, the low value plastic in my house, is going here. So this is just a number that about 8,500 crores of these sachets, shampoo, toffee, sanitizer, everything. They're enough to cover the entire surface of the earth. That is how much. Now, this is very quickly, somebody was asking me about e-waste. So this is what your e-waste is: your batteries, bulb, tube light, printer, cartridge, wire, CD, mobile phone, geyser, printer,
music system,
laptop, iPad, fridge, LCD, LED, washing machine, all this. So they need to be given to an authorized e-waste recycler. Please never ever give them to your kabadi wala, because kabadi wala does not have the equipment. Now, you know, usually what they do is that in order to take out the copper from the wire, they burn all that plastic. And he's also inhaling that plastic. And obviously there is no effluent treatment system for this thing. So whatever water they are using, they're just directly releasing the water like that. And usually it is happening in the slum areas. About batteries, you should know this. I've shared this last time also, that 2.7 billion pieces of dry cell batteries are consumed in India every year, and 92.5% batteries are thrown into the bin without segregation. And when the cover of these batteries or dry cells corrode, the heavy metal inside mixes with the soil and contaminate the groundwater and surface water, thus entering our food chain through fruits and vegetables. So that small battery that you love to use may be deadly. Please never ever throw your batteries inside your bins that are going to the landfill. Just keep collecting them. Keep collecting them. Collect them for 1 year, 2 years, 3 years maybe. Keep collecting them and give it to an authorized e-waste recycler. If you don't find one, if any of you has a relative coming to Gurgaon, you can come here. There are three centers that we have here, which can be where you can come and deposit. Otherwise, with your teachers, I can share CPCB. There are a lot of authorized e-waste recyclers, and soon the commissioner of your municipal, North Delhi Municipal Corporation, it was there in the papers about 2 days back, that they are going to be making these e-waste parks where people can go and deposit their e-waste. So make sure that you don't send your e-waste like that. In Gurgaon, you can find it on the internet. There is a Samadhan hub that we have. You can come and you can give it here. That's the best that I can tell you right now, because the minute I come to know about one in Delhi, I promise I will share it with all of you. I'll share it with your teacher so that it reaches you all. All right. You should know this, that glass and aluminium are infinitely recyclable without any loss of purity or quality. And it is very important that you do that. Please don't break it. Keep it and give it to your kabadi wala. Again, collect it and give it to your kabadi wala. Even the aluminium foil that the mamma wraps the roti inside, everything can be just rinsed and given it. And in the end, I just want to share this guy, that world record for tubby recycling Labrador from Torofin. Like, if a Labrador can do it, I'm sure human beings can do it, right? This Labrador picks up discarded plastic bottles in his mouth and crushes them. Has made it in 2011 Guinness Book of World Records. So if human behavior is something that we all need to alter, we need to check, we need to be very, very conscious about what we are doing with our environment. Again, we are all a product of our environment, and our goal is not to make an environment out of our products. So please be careful. This is, again, I was talking that living biomass is only gigatons 4, and plastic and human-made mass has already reached 8 gigatons. So that's all from my side. I hope you all enjoyed the session today.
Yes, ma'am.
Please note down my email address. It's roma.vinayak@gmail.com. If you have any questions that I couldn't answer, please email me and I shall try my level best to get back to you all with all your doubts and questions.
Ma'am, can you write it in chat? Ma'am, write your email in chat.
Okay, I'll just do that.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, can I ask my doubt here? Because it is very small.
Ma'am, I have made something.
Yes, tell me better.
Ma'am, from the plastic bottle.
Oh, lovely. See, that is the best form of doing that. Reusing it. Okay, first is reduce, refuse, reuse, recycle, and then in the end, we send it to... Recycling is like our last option. But before that, first refuse it, reuse it, then recycle it.
Children, you can drop your questions to ma'am because it's already, time is...
Yes, we are very, very late.
Yeah. So you can leave your questions. Thanks a lot, ma'am.
Thank you so much, ma'am. And it was lovely having you all. Children, I look forward to your questions. Please look after the environment. Be the green warriors, green army soldiers that I just, this thing, and carry on with the good work. And together we shall save it. Okay? You can be in touch with me. And
ma'am, that table phone.
Ma'am, where is the test link?
Yes. I think ma'am is going to share that with you. So,
okay.
Jyot ma'am had the test link. Okay. All the best. It's a very easy test. You'll all pass.
Thank you, ma'am.
We will share the link later. Children, just a second. Just a second, ma'am. I would like to express my gratitude and to all the participants of the webinar for their presence and contribution to make this webinar a great success. I extend my sincere thanks to Ms. Roma Vinayak for giving her valuable time, school authorities, and wonderful audience today. A very warm thanks to all. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Have a lovely day, all of you. It was great meeting you all. And I hope to see the green warriors in you. Okay. Continue to carry on your waste segregation and just don't let anyone trash the planet. Right?
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you, children.
Bye-bye. Thank you so much,
thank
ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Bye, ma'am.
Thank you,
ma'am. Sir, please end the meeting.
I will.
Bye, ma'am. Thank you.
Bye, ma'am.